The stream is on. Let it begin.
So, everybody except for Lance, I'm assuming, is at Elven Tree. You guys have... is Cass still with a faction? I can't remember.
Yeah, I'm with the Order of the...
Order of the Gauntlet?
Yes.
Alright, cool. I believe Bane is as well.
Yep.
So it's just some little makeshift thing I made. This is Elven Tree. This is basically the hub of this season's adventures. I'll get rid of him. So Lance, you're not there, but your token's there. But and since we're back to expeditions, everybody's full healed. Everybody's spell slots are back. Everything, long rest, everything that resets gets reset. So take care of that. So Lance has his own thing, but pretty much I don't know if anybody read the synopsis I had on the front page, but this one's called Bane of the Tradeways. Times are hard in the hills far countryside, especially for those of non-human ancestry. Unscrupulous merchants in league with the hated red plumes bleed local farmers and artisans dry. Perhaps some of those loot-laden caravans coming and going from hills far could use a bit of liberation. So there is an area in between, get my maps out. I think this is probably where, yeah. This isn't the best map, but they might have something better in Sword Coast. But if you like zoom in on that, you see Hillsfar in the middle there, kind of. And then to the west is, it says Ulash, which I think is still in ruins. This is a pretty old map. But right in between there, there's a place called The Stop. And usually caravans come and go from there to Hillsfar. Especially with the farmers, especially a lot of the farmers around Hillsfar aren't human, so they can't really have access to the city to get their goods in there, so they have to have these, I guess, basically like middlemen to get goods in there. And as of late, there has been people have been talking about bandits attacking the caravans coming and going from there. And let's see, basically your factions, they want you to give them a report of the state of affairs in the area around the stop. There's actually here. I got this too. If you want to read that. Of course, the band would know that since you had dealings with Flan, and you actually helped get set up that deal with those halfling farmers, remember, for the wheat. There's so many refugees from Flan and Elven Tree now. They need a lot more food, but these shipments of food have not been coming in. And when they do, it's just like long distances in between, and it's they're wondering what's going on with this. basically, why don't you go check it out and give them some intel on this situation. All right, let me put my clock up. That way I make sure.
So where do we start? Do we head towards the stop?
Yeah, I'm just gonna... Oops, shit.
We're going to have to take a big detour around Hills Far, aren't we?
Yeah, I would assume you would just kind of, go around there. I'll get right into it.
Oh, yeah, you guys said that I would like Hills Far.
Crixus, did you take care of the things we talked about?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
I spent 450 gold for the Great Restoration and 1 copper for the Whetstone.
Okay, cool.
So I'm sharpening my axe.
Cool, deal. All right. Didn't Ban get hit too with by an ooze?
By an ooze? Yeah, it trashed my sword.
Did you want, like, the way I kind of played it with Crixus is if you wanted to spend a copper for a whetstone, you could sharpen up your sword back to normal. But if it gets hit again with something similar, it's going to go back. It's going to go, like, what was it, -1? It'll go to -2. Like, it won't go start over.
Well,
or you could just buy a new one, and then you don't have to worry about it.
That was kind of my plan. Well, right now I've got that mace that
burst
into green fire.
All right, never mind. Forget it.
So I think I'm going to be running around with that groovy little toy for a while.
So you go, what I think is like a days and a half journey to pass Hills Far. And let me get back to this one. You go past, giving Hills Far a wide berth. And finally, you can still kind of see it, and it's disappearing from you in the distance. Suddenly, you hear the thunderous approach of horses from behind you. A number of impressively adorned riders storm past you without as much of a glance in your direction. It's like horses just like are almost hit you because they're like hauling butt. But they're heavy mounts. They have shiny black coats and gleaming barding, and clearly bred for battle. The crimson tabards of Hillsfar and bright red plumes atop their helms accent the soldiers' fine armor. It is an impressive display, but they are as gone as quickly as they arrived.
Jerks.
So, it wants me at this time to, I'm assuming this is for, like, if new players are here, introduce characters, explain what they've done or seen in the Hillsfar area. I know three of you have been playing together for a while, but I don't know if you wanted to give your opinions on Hillsfar to Castile, since he hasn't really experienced the whole xenophobia. I don't know.
He's a human, isn't he?
Yeah, he is human, so...
What does he care?
Yeah. Maybe that's the better question.
Yeah. I don't like that place. I got to hold somebody's hand if I'm walking around there in the open. Make it look like I'm...
That? Yeah.
Yeah. So basically, yeah, if with the new lord, he reenacted the law of humanity, so if you're not human, you're not allowed in the city at all. And they've experienced some renegade red plumes who have just been basically enforcing the law outside of the city too, and then just capturing non-humans and sending them to the arena to fight to the death kind of thing. So I don't know, just be thinking about your position on Hillsfar.
I don't like it already.
All right. Good deal.
I'm not a fan.
Yeah, I don't think any of the humans in the party like Hillsfar, so. Topping a small hill, you hear the sharp clang of metal echoing through the forest canopy. Clang, clang. Looking down the hill to a small creek ford, you see a group of red plumes engaged with several non-human assailants who have clearly ambushed them. One unfortunate soldier dangles from an overhanging branch, having been lassoed around the neck and hauled aloft, his face nearly blue and his legs jerk and flail in a macabre jig of death. A number of horses in red plume livery are scattered around the area. A handful of lifeless corpses lay on the ground. So we'll get right to it. The ones with X's are dead bodies. But you see
So are you saying that the red plumes were ambushed?
Yeah, the red plumes were ambushed.
Am I there with them, or am I at the stop?
You are actually coming in from up here, in this way.
Ah.
Yeah, we agreed.
You just happen to come in at the same exact time.
Like, and whoa, see. This is crazy!
Hey, I know you.
Dude. What? So, the dead people are red plumes, right? The horses are alive.
The horses are alive, and they're starting to freak out. Some of them are turning. This one is wanting to run away. Starting to go. It's actually a mixture of both. It's like they were ambushed, and then they strung this one guy up, and he's actually flailing around. He's not quite dead yet. But these other guys are bandits who seem to be attacking, and so they're engaged in battle.
I don't know. I think I should spend my turn making popcorn.
Really? I don't know which side I want to be on this one, except for maybe snagging a horse. I got to do it. I draw my mace and yell, green flame, so it lights up.
Hang on, let me
start moving on him.
Let me see if this, I guess you can see the whole map because I have a global illumination on, so that's cool. Green flame.
Yeehaw.
All right, well, let's get this party started.
I don't have a lot of choice in the matter.
You goody two-shoes. Well, that's like the whole Order of the Gauntlet, right? They're protectors. Like.
Yeah. Although, I really don't like those red plumes.
So, Ban, what are we killing?
Yeah, exactly.
I'm happy to follow you into battle, but I don't know, am I hitting everything?
I'm going after the bandits first.
Okay, you take the bandits, I'll take the red plumes.
There you go. That's divisional labor.
All right.
Oh, God.
Initiative.
Thor, why did you abandon me?
No.
Is each square 5 feet?
Yes, it is.
Square and a hex map at the same time, kinda.
Yeah.
All right. Is that everybody? All right, cool. Round one. Basically, the horses are skittering off to the edge. They're scared. They're scared. You see this horse coming towards you, Lance.
Hey, free horse.
Yeah.
How about that? Castile's up.
Oh, what's going on? Oh. Sorry, I was updating myself. We're in a fight. Okay.
Yeah. Who are you?
That guy?
They're one of them's looking over you. This guy looks like He's more dressed in, I guess, cavalry attire. And it looks like he might have some kind of insignia of rank of sergeant.
That's a red plume, right?
Yeah, he's definitely a red plume. But he's looking over and he's like, "Help me! In the name of the law, help!" And then you see, this is probably like a halfling, some kind of bandit guy. He's just like, "No! Help the people! Come on!" And then they're all fighting.
Hey,
well, I don't know. What are you guys fighting?
So this guy's probably gonna be a lawman, and this guy looks like some kind of soldier.
Yeah, he's basically.
And that's all we know.
Yeah, the red plumes are basically the police force of Hillsfar.
They're racist.
They're pretty much they're like
species human supremacists.
Oh, so these are the Hillsfar dudes.
Yeah, if you're not human, yeah, they.
that made the decision much easier.
It's still a hard decision for me.
Not too hard for me, I'll tell you that right now.
Do you need me to go ahead and pop an initiative?
Yeah, go for it. Go, Gadget.
Come on. Fire. I light myself first. Here we go.
Racism is the domain of evil, and I am not a fan of evil.
Yes, I agree.
Okay,
knock
so
off all that evil.
What have I missed?
There's really no point, and it'll just waste time trying to catch up. So, red plumes versus bandits. Pick a side. So.
Okay.
I think Crixus is going to go red plumes, and I'm going to go bandits.
Oh. You managed to find a weakness in the armor and get through. Bam. And yeah. 6, 12 slashing.
I'll go ahead and pop my bonus.
You hit it, but the other side, the blunt side, it just kind of bangs on his armor. He's like,
dang.
Yeah.
I'll stop there.
But yeah, but that was a good hit.
I messed up. Would I be allowed to, I was gonna stop here and use my superiority dice to make a lunging attack.
Yeah, a little bit too late for that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry. So who removed? Okay.
Yeah, he's removed right there, and he is just going to assist. He is going to assist the what race is the other bandits, by the way?
Like halflings, gnomes, dwarves.
Perfect. He's going to assist the halfling to the north of the red plume.
Okay. Cool. All right. And then it's actually his turn, so I'm just going to swing on the one to the left.
Oh, he's going to try to take out the horse. That's mean.
No, he's not going to. 11. Wow, that hits. I imagine he was using two hands, so that's only 6. All right. Wonder if these get 2 attacks or not. I don't think they do. Cavalry. Makes 2 melee attacks. All right, he does get another attack. 10 this time. So, he makes a pretty good blow to this rebel guy. Gets his shoulder pretty hard. He's like, And that's it for him. Archon.
Okay. First things first. Casting Shillelagh on my staff. And I'm guessing that, like, this area right here is rough terrain getting through the brush.
It's probably like raised up. Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't count it as difficult. That's fine.
All right, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Okay, and I'm still showing myself as damaged from last time. I take it we had healed up, or?
Yeah, we healed up, yeah.
Okay. And so I'll be able to get in one swing, since I'm assuming that's who Castile was swinging at.
No, actually, he was swinging at the sergeant.
Oh, was he? Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, because basically I'm looking for whoever my party members are that had already swung at somebody. That's where I'm helping. So.
Yeah, actually, he has a pole arm, so he swung at.
Well, then I can turn around since I only went 25. 30, 35.
I mean, you could totally side with the rep plumes. That's up to you.
No. I'm siding with my party, whoever they happen to go against. Right. So I will take a swipe at the red plume.
All right.
We just got to make sure that nobody finds out that we swung at the red
plume. That's right. You got to kill them all. It could be a problem if they try to surrender with the pally in the group.
Mm-hmm. He hears you coming for some reason and is on guard and dodges out of the way. So,
okay.
All right. Lance.
So this tree up here, is that like a tall tree, or is this what is this right here?
Can I walk under it? You could walk under it. I would say this square right here would be difficult to walk around. The one you're in right now.
Okay, I'll just go there. I am just simply going to cast Frostbite on this guy right here.
Okay. Isn't that the AoE one? Oh, or you can shape it.
No, right. Frostbite. No, Frostbite. Oh. Not Frost. Oh, okay. Ice Knight.
All right. So con.
DC's now 5% tougher to resist. Didn't I needed 10% tougher barely to resist. Oh, well.
So close. All right. All right. Thugs are up. He's going to attack. Actually, CG got him, so he's going to face this guy. Multi-attack. He does have multi-attack. Okay. I hope it doesn't multi-attack right. Oh. Okay. So swings with the mace and swings again. Oof. Ah, just can't get through the dude's armor. Just like. And this one it goes. Swings twice with the mace. Ah, really? Doesn't get through the armor. Bippadoosh. This one goes twice on the cavalry. Oh, eight crits. 7, 8, 9. And that's all that he does. This one attacks twice. Wow. 22 and 16. One of them hits for 7. Alright, taking a beating. Is that? Oh, this one right here. He swings twice. 19. Ooh, actually hits twice. Oh! Bandit takes him down. Takes down the sergeant.
Thud. Splash.
And so that's one of them. Okay. Alright, Ban.
This green flame. Yeah.
And just since I don't see the little indicator on your picture, Jason, are you currently streaming?
Yeah, I am.
Okay.
There was one guy actually watching us for a little bit, or he was in the chat.
All right, Ben looks over and sees that red bloom drop and looks at this guy, looks at the rest of the party and goes, who are we attacking? And then he takes a swing at the bandit.
Oh, man. It's a no prisoner day.
Hey, that's fair game.
Oh boy.
We're independent. We take out everybody.
I guess so.
That's a hit. That's totally.
Oh, is that a hit?
Yeah.
Oh, right on.
Minus.
Thump.
And then since it's lit, did you include the plus one for the flame damage in there?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah. So,
okay. All right. Oh wait, dude, is that? Are they all? Oh, I see what just happened. All these freaking tokens are connected. No.
So when you drop 2 points, I want it dropped them on all of them.
Yeah, there are some of these that are actually still. God dang it. I hate when it does that.
I noticed that with the two up top, but I just thought you used both attacks to hit one each or something, so I didn't.
It's because when you actually use the HP thing in Roll 20, it like. If you just have one entry of the token, it does through the whole freaking thing. It's annoying as shit. It's crap. But anyway, I don't even remember what they were. Oh, well, screw it. We'll just say they've been fighting and whatever. That's fine. So, I'm not going to worry about it. No, I'm lagging. Yeah, let's give it a second, let it catch up, because I'm lagging. All right, there we go. Yeah, Ban just cut out, too. All right. Roll 20 heard me talk crap about it, so they're like, we'll give him lag. All right, let me just refresh real quick, because I hate this crap. Alright, that's better. A lot better. Lost Ban, though. Did anybody else hear him or see him?
No. I don't see him.
Matt C, you might need a refresh. But, who's up? He attacked him. Alright. He's dead. Crixus.
Let's go 5, 10, 15, 25, and then attack the red plume to the north.
All right. This is not quite enough. It just manages to catch on his armor, and it gets lucky, and it can't get through the armor. This guy in the tree, he just seems to be slowly shaking less and less. he's dying. He would probably see if they get 2 attacks. Oh, 2 melee attacks. All right. The other one's not down yet. Okay. So attack on him. Which he would probably actually have more of his hit points, so I'll just add that.
Is everybody else attacking the red plumes? Am I the only one that attacked a bandit? Yeah. Is that what happened?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna have to explain to do in a few minutes, I bet.
Because I'm really confused now. Well, Ban's really confused. I know what happened.
This are guy.
We good guys?
He crits.
Yes. That's why we're attacking the reptiles.
And the reptiles are definitely not good guys.
They're jerks, but they're not like demons.
Yeah. If you know, non-humans aren't demons either. You need to get that mindset out of your head.
Yeah, yeah. We just laid out our weapons in the middle of combat to have a discussion.
Well, hold on a second. Meanwhile, everybody's battling around us.
Kill the other ones. Okay, so round two.
Can't we all just get along?
Yeah.
Horses just still neighing and getting scared from all the battle going on. Castile, you are back up.
Aha. I'm gonna go help Crixus. Back up.
He's like, whoa.
Good. Hey.
He's like, holding his longsword. Come on, you pansy.
And I'm actually gonna spend a dice to try to tempt him for to make that a tripping attack.
No. Oh.
Why doesn't it expend them on you?
I don't know. I know this character. Well, I think there's a way. Well, I know there's a way you can set up to do with ammo, but and there's probably a macro you can set up. I just don't know the formula for it. But
no. So I've got to look at it. So that is.
But yeah, that would be cool if it did that.
Trip attack. It's a DC 13 strength saving throw.
DC 13 strength.
Yeah. Oh, excuse me, I have to roll the dice.
Oh. Well, he got a 19.
Okay. So, and then it's 2 more damage.
2 damage? Okay.
And then I'll go ahead and use my bonus.
Well, do you have to, like, hit it? That's just the thing, right? You don't have to hit him to do that.
I have to hit him.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, yeah. Go ahead and see if you hit him. Oh. Uh oh.
Yipes.
Ouch.
And that's my turn.
Okay. Man, I was trying to have these things. Probably can't hear it. Ah. My sound effects aren't working, huh? Oh, well.
Is that a sad trombone?
I was trying to. Did y'all hear it? I don't know. I was just missing one.
Oh, that was on the initial.
Yeah. All right, cool. It's Al's turn.
He's going to be assisting me trying to distract the spread plume right there.
Okay. And he's up now. He's kind of thinking twice about this. He's going to disengage. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. What's it? 30. So he's gonna try to run. Archon. Oh no, wait. Yeah, that's right. Archon's up. Yeah, you notice this one actually looks like he's dressed a tiny bit different too. Like, he's dressed in, like, cavalry officer's attire.
Okay. I'll be good,
though. That's as far as I can go unless I want to dash, so I will stop there and I am going to use a key point to basically to dodge for the rest of the turn. That way if he comes after me, I can avoid him.
Okay. All right. Sorry, Lance.
That's all right. Hey, so I'm moving over here. Hi, Max. This is one question. I know you said there was gnomes and halflings kind of mixed. Are one of these two people alive up north, on the north side, at least one of them a gnome?
Sure.
Okay. We'll see. Before I cast Burning Hands on the last guy alive, I'm going to look to my left and go, "Don't worry, brother. I got this one."
And I'll nice.
That's important for afterwards here. Okay. Straight up at him. Hopefully that's enough. He looked like he was low.
You're shooting at the guy trying to run away?
Yep. Hopefully drop him.
Dex.
And I want them to notice that.
Oh. 18. Safe for half, though.
Yeah.
Fine. He had 4 left.
Yay, it'll work.
You get him down.
Smoldering in the water.
Okay. These guys are gonna attack. It's one hit. He moves over to engage. Oh, one hit, one fumble. Takes 8. And these guys. Oh, I did set up the languages. So if you whisper to a language, and you speak that language, then you should be able to see the what they're saying. Because he said something back to you, and it's in chat. I think, Lance, you should be able to see that.
Oh, does it say if it's in another language or not?
Well, on my side it says to Gnomish, but I don't know if it says that on your side.
Oh, no, I just see from DM Jason.
Oh,
that sucks. And then the message, so I don't see that it's
in another language. I probably have to select it down here, but it's just more for flavor.
Okay, so that was from the character.
Yeah. That guy, they're not going to cut him down, so it's going to 5, 10, 15... 20, 25, and it's gonna hit. He's like, "You leave our people alone!" And he hits once. 5. This guy is like, he seems like more worried about his peeps. He's gonna see if he can do anything to save him, so he's just gonna spend an action trying to bandage up this guy. So, Ban.
Okay. I'm gonna swing on that guy in front of me again.
Oh, God. Alright.
Oh, my.
You hit him so hard with a mace, you break his neck.
Well, hold on a second. If I take him to 0 hit points, can I choose to just knock him?
Yeah, if you choose to knock him unconscious, you can do that. Yeah,
you can. I'm just gonna bonk.
Okay. All right. All right. That's a good idea. All right. Do you move or do you stay? The guy is like, what? What? Another human?
Yeah, that's what I am. I yell at both of them, "Knock it off!"
Alright.
I'm not on really either one of their sides.
I know.
You know what I mean?
Oh, I know.
You guys are breaking the law. You guys are jerks. You know, I don't know.
That's a good point. They look like bandits.
You know, if I have to put the thump down on both of them, I will.
You see no race.
Crixus.
The guy hanging from a tree, what's his situation like? Is he dead, dying?
In one more round, it looks like he's gonna just be out. You could try to cut him down if you wanted to.
I'll chop him down.
Alright. He's like 20 feet up. The rope's 20 feet up. But I guess you could like undo the rope. So okay, that's cool. You untie it, and you manage to get him down. And it's like he goes unconscious, but you can see he's still breathing. So
yeah, I punch him in the face just to make sure.
All right. He takes one damage.
He takes one damage and fails his last death saving throw.
I just skipped over him. So this guy, yeah, he's not having this. He's gonna disengage. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. He's running away. Castile. So yeah, it's like chaos. The red plume's on the ground. Other one's running away. The bandits are like, what's up with this dude?
Sure, no other red plumes off in the distance.
That's it. Okay. You forget something?
Yes.
So he's gonna run. I guess he actually has to get 10 feet out of your reach. So he's gonna get like to here, and you can get a opportunity.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Right there. Yeah. Yeah.
Got no spirit.
Yeah. You take him down. So just because we got about 5 till 10 right now, so. I'm going to just take it out of combat and we can RP this part. There's a unconscious red plume on the ground. All the rest are dead. There's horses about.
Does this bandit look like he's going to try to tangle with me? Because that's going to end badly for him.
I think it would
he's kind of size. He's just like, why are you attacking our people? You should be on our side.
Why? Why should I be on your side?
Because these red plumes are just overrunning us with their stupid law of humanity and getting in the way of everything. It's so ridiculous. They're doing everything.
Hang them from trees. Okay, that's how the law works.
Hey.
Nope.
just
drag your buddy out of the stream before he drowns.
As you hear some rustling in the trees about right here, and this guy comes out. He's a dwarf guy. He's like, "What in the Nine Hills happened here?" He's like, "Ugh," and you see him. He starts going over. He's like starts pickpocketing this guy on the ground, and then he runs over. Here, around, and he just starts looting bodies.
Dude, really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
In front of us?
Yeah.
Just right in front of us.
Yeah.
Like, hold up, bud.
This one's mine.
I try to talk to the gnomish guy up north.
And you actually see more bandits coming out from the surrounding forested area. And you're basically like all surrounded by bandits. You see them all. They're trying to pull these soldiers to where they're like hidden. So they're trying to, you know, get their bodies assorted. Obviously they don't want the plumes to be seen.
Yeah, I get that. Can I try talking to the gnome guy?
Sure.
I'd be like, hey, brother, I'm glad we were there to help out and everything. And I hate these red plumes too and stuff. But, dude, man, killing them outright's not going to make this, is not going to solve the problem. They're not going to just start loving inhumans again. You know what I'm saying? What's going on, dude?
Just speaks to you in gnomish. They're not doing good stuff to the farmers. You might want to talk to old Dumb Carl. He's the one who's in charge here. He hired us.
I'm sorry, what's his name you said? Old Dumb Carl?
Dumb Carl.
Dumb Carl.
Yeah.
All right. Hey, Carl!
Hey, Carl! He, you notice the sergeant guy, he cuts a coin purse off from him, and, he throws it over to Crixus, and he's like, here's for your trouble. And, throws it to you. He's like, looks, I admit it looks bad, but I can only offer you that there's a good reason. We could use folk like you. Seeing how you did kind of confront, but you helped him too, so he's like, he kind of looks around, at the gnome, and he starts heading towards the gnome, and he talks to this guy, man, is there any way we could patch him up? And the gnome's just like, shakes his head, no, they're gone. And he's like, damn. He's like, look, talks to Lance, look, there's a red plume caravan on the move, and we aim to stop it. Are you in or are you not?
You know, here's the thing, man. I'm all about finding a way to resolve this, though, but direct conflict, just killing them outright, is not going to bring a good solution for everything. It's just not. I'm going to try to convince him. I don't know how much time I have to talk to him, but I need to convince him that killing other humans is not going to make the humans want to start accepting demi-humans again. There's got to be a different way.
Oh, suit yourself. All right, it's 10. He's like, come on, boys. He's like, yeah, that's. He's just like, come on, let's get out of here.
Is there another way of helping besides just slaughtering them?
It's up to y'all. What do you want to do?
Hold on. Let me talk to my friends here. See what we can come up with.
He's all, I don't have time. I have to go now. You're either with us or you're not. You can tend to your plume, boys. And he starts going off. He starts running. Everybody else starts coming, following him, and they're booking it.
Ben, I know you're against killing a whole bunch of red plumes. I have no problem with it, but I know it's not going to be the right fix action.
Yeah, I'm not really down with that. I want to lay on hands on this guy at least for a little bit, a few points, like 3 or 4 points, enough to get him conscious again so he can join his buddies.
I don't know. Do we want to help? I'm down for definitely disrupting a red plume caravan. I don't know about just slaughtering a bunch of them, but I'll definitely break some carts from a distance.
Did anybody else say anything to the dwarf, or are you just gonna let him run off?
They plan to attack a carriage right after. They just got good reasons I would stop them.
Okay, because it's like it's actually like a lot more than bandits. They're all heading off to somewhere.
What is the deal with the caravan? Why do they want to stop it?
He said, "There's no time." He's like, "I know time. I can explain it on the way."
Can we talk later and agree later if that's the case?
That's fine. Well, I'm not necessarily pleased that you let my friends get themselves killed. I'm glad you chose not to help all of them red plumes. He said, "Look, if you want to earn some coin and blacken the red plume's eye while you're at it, then I suggest you follow me."
I'm going to hold you to your word. I'm down for blackening an eye, not sticking a sword through it.
All right, fair enough. He's like, fine. Sabotage. Help us sabotage, and we'll give you some coin.
I'm down for some sabotage for him. That's cool. I don't know. What do you guys think?
It just depends on what the caravan is for. If they're taking medical supplies to a camp outside of, you know what I'm saying?
Oh man, you're pushing. I will go along with that. Medical supplies, we're not going to mess with them. But if they're just doing their standard rain and destruction, being dicks,
you know what, jacking up today. Yeah, if they're taking stuff they've stolen off of innocent demihumans, then yeah.
This guy doesn't really look like he didn't participate in the fight and doesn't really look like he knows how to fight, really. He looks like more he's in a cower. But he almost looks more like a farmer type of person.
This dumb Charlie.
Probably, I don't know.
I'm down with getting a little more information.
Yeah.
I mean, really, we got to find this, the other stuff going on around here anyway, so why not?
We just sort of ran into the middle of this, as proven by the fact that I was beating up bandits and everybody else was beating up red blokes.
I mean, maybe we go back to where they're at, we can ask about the slaving and other stuff like that if they know anything about it, so.
Damn.
Yeah. If we get questioned about the red plumes, I'm saying you killed them all. You struck first. So, just want to, like, in case you didn't know, as for Jason, for Lance, that the email I sent you about is actually a faction assignment, a special assignment for Zentrum in here. So if you actually succeed on that, then you get an extra renown point.
Gotcha. So.
You got homework.
Yeah.
So we're back to the expedition type of adventures. So this is just kind of like they throw you in to situations. You do, you don't, you, or there's pretty much no adventure. So that's like I told you, dude, we can do two, but I'm going to railroad you. So
that's cool.
Everybody was okay with that. Right. So you basically used, one of the rewards that you can take from this is you can actually get free mounts. If y'all want to each pick a horse.
I'm a pony kind of guy.
Yeah, there's no ponies, but if you don't want your own horse, then you could saddle up with someone else, I guess.
I'll certainly take a horse.
You can ride on the handlebars.
Somebody needs to give me a boost on a horse.
I want this one. I want the black one with the red saddle.
I got this one right here.
I'm gonna take the one that ran to me because it loved me so much.
I'm on the horse. It's mine. Claimed.
All right, let me
carve my name in it.
All right, whose is whose? No way again. Okay, this one's Castile's. That way.
I'll just take the one that ran past me.
I'd like to look for any markings on it that identify it as Red Plume property and remove it.
Was one of the
With like a belt sander? What are you going to do to take it off?
Well, if there's like a thing hanging on it or something like that.
I mean, I think it means like saddle-wise.
Oh, I was thinking like a brand.
The Archon one, which horses are left? Okay,
it's Crixus. What I'm trying to figure out is which horses are
left. I think probably this one right there. You got the blondie.
That's okay. The one I snagged.
My bad. Sorry. It puts you under him for some reason, so I'm trying to do it by your guys' colors.
There's a gray, a white, a brown, a blonde.
I don't want a cow. You can put me on any one of them.
This one. Oh, this one up here on the corner. Here, I'll bring it down to you. Okay, so you guys are. I'm just gonna move it over here for now. So as you guys are heading through the forest, he starts jab chatting with you. So the farming area used to be good business, but recently the merchant representatives at the stop are not paying what they used to for crop yields. The human farmers seem to get better treatment, usually in the form of higher prices for their harvests. Sadly, the representatives are the only option because since us non-human farmers are banned from entering the city to sell their crops for themselves. The guild in Hillsfar offers loans against the values of the farm to allow them to pay for planting the next season. These red plumes have been in the pocket of the merchants for a while now. Carl learned of the shipment of important cargo 2 days ago. He doesn't know what's being moved, but has received word of heavily armored wagons. Whatever it is, it's not bushels of grain.
Do you know of anything about people being abducted from the area? Labor activity?
We have heard of some such rumors, but we have no proof of it.
Like if they're out hiring more quote-unquote gladiators, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm definitely not down with that.
What areas are these rumors coming from? Is there a certain area around here?
All farmlands. All the non-human farmlands. Which, if you remember, pretty much most of your adventures have been at farms, and they've been just y'all have been to like all around Hillsfar, so.
What is your plan to stop this caravan, first of all? I mean, what do you know about it? Do you know how many people there are? How many carts? Anything?
Not really, but we have heard word that it's going to be coming down the road.
So you've done no reconnaissance whatsoever.
The thing is, we don't want to miss it if it's there. I'm not exactly sure of the time, but I don't want to be late. I don't want to miss it. But the only thing I do know, it's we've heard of heavily armored wagons, so I assume there's more than one.
I mean, so what's your plan? Just to kill a bunch of red blooms, or are you going to dig a hole and hide it in the road, hoping to break the cart, maybe? Or what's your plan?
Chase it, get up to it, break it open, do whatever we have to do. I don't know. I guess I haven't really thought that ahead.
Well, and I'll look at Van when I tell him this. What would happen if we get there, we kill them all, we break it open, and there's a whole bunch of medical supplies that's going to another human settlement?
Well, look, if that happens on an armored wagon, then I'd be highly surprised. Yeah, listen to your friend here.
I'll look at Van and be like, you're the one that's got to be okay with this.
Well, that'll be between me and Torm at that point. You know what I mean? I'll roll the dice on that one.
I just want to make sure you're okay, because I'll sleep with myself pretty well at the end of the day here.
We already had to fight as gladiators for him once. I wouldn't wish that on anybody.
What do you mean? That was like the greatest day ever.
It was a lot of fun, but still. Not for those halflings.
for halflings.
Exactly.
Oh, exactly.
Oops. All right. So let me just read this text to you. Oh, this is going to be such a mess. Ah. Got like one person watching. Sorry about this mess, one viewer. So you hear it before you see it. The thunderous hoof beats of horses and the rattle of wagons fills the air as the road appears before you. Suddenly, a trio of armored wagons speed past the road just as you break through the trees. In response to your appearance, in a shrill whistle sounds. Riders behind, a red plume shouts as he sees you. Horses, spears, and bows. The chase is on. And... all right, let's roll initiative. Okay. Dang it, I got it stuck in my head.
Yeah. Just think of Plinko.
19. I guess who is that?
Is that all the red plumes we see? Or is there a bunch more horses than that? For guards and stuff.
Four red plume patrol, one driving each wagon with an additional patrol riding in wagon three. I think that's it.
Are they carriages or are they wagons?
Like I said, it's not accurately depicted. It's just they're armored wagons and they're closed up. I can give you a more accurate description if you want.
What's in them?
No.
What is the top made out of? Are they like wooden carriages and that guy's on the top of the carriage?
Let me read you the accurate description. The wagons consist of three fortified wagons. Each wagon is 10 feet long and led by four draft horses wearing half plate barding. The horses are large. So basically you can do these actions while you're riding. You can do fall behind as a bonus action on your turn. A character driving a wagon or riding a mount may rein the wagon or mount and fall behind. This requires no check. Move ahead as a bonus action on your turn. The character driving a wagon or riding a mount may attempt to get a surge of speed from the horses leading it. A successful DC 10 wisdom animal handling check allows the mount or vehicle to move ahead. Add proficiency if you have the vehicle's land tool. Failure results in the mount or the horses leading the wagon winding themselves, causing them to fall behind instead. Okay, the wagons can do that. Here's a driving wagon. Travel, okay. A leap. As an action, a character or other bandit may attempt to leap from their horse or wagon to an adjacent wagon. This requires a successful DC 10 Dex acrobatics check. If you fail, you take 3 bludgeoning damage, fall prone. Okay, here you go. Crate obstacle. A character can try to throw something, a crate, a cart, another creature, in the way of the pursuers to hamper their movement. A character that succeeds on a DC 13 athletics check strikes the target, causing their next ability check or saving throw to be made with disadvantage. Wagon is destroyed during pursuit if it is reduced to zero hit points, or if a horse is killed and it crashes and topples over. If destroyed, the wagon stops, and all passengers take 7 bludgeoning. So yeah, admittedly, this mounted combat is not something I've really done much as in 5th at all.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think I've ever done it. So it says once you're about 15 feet, so I imagine you're all there.
What's his business on either side of the road? Are these trees or something?
Yeah, it's just the greenery. Yeah, I didn't. Okay. It's just my crappy little map.
So is there one red plume per cart, like driving it, basically?
Pretty much, yeah. It said there was actually an additional plume in this one.
And I take it these guard horses, there's probably red plumes on the horses as well, I assume, riding alongside.
Yeah, actually, it didn't say there was these. I was assuming that these are bandits helping you guys.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, even better.
So yeah. Oh, is your owl? Yeah, there are owls out there.
Can you cast from the back of a mounted horse while it's moving?
If it's concentration, you might have to do a concentration check, but I mean, yeah, there's nothing that says you can't. Okay. So who is up?
All he can do is fly up to the lead horse and try to distract him and confuse him. Maybe, I don't know, do anything to piss him off. I don't know. That's it.
As you say, have him dive bomb the horse's head and try to startle it.
Yeah, just trying to freak him out.
There we go. Hit points. I guess it's actually supposed to be the bandit, not the red plume. So he's going to try to move ahead. So he's going to try animal handling check. Oh! Manages to get ahead. Manages surge of speed. He's going to try to. Succeeds. I don't think they're really counting exact measurements on this horse thing. It just says, get ahead. So. Bonus section. Is that Archon's thing again? Yeah, I'll mute him, see if... Alright, there we go. I think he's the only one that doesn't use headphones, so it's like always like... Whoosh. Anyway. Yeah. Oh wait, that's bonus action, so what? He's gonna... Can you try to leap on? I just heard the bandit trying to leap on from the horse.
I How would you play it if Castile tried to shove like a halberd into the one of the wheel wells of the wagon?
Yeah. When as they were trying to get ahead, yeah, he's gonna try to leap on here. Like, oh my god, Bandit fumbles, dude. Or I guess there's really no fumble, but. So Bandit falls down here, and this one was gonna try the same. Ho! He leaps on. Oh, covered him up. God dang it! Here, I know how to fix this. There it's we trampled. Go. Trampled. Man, it said that this combat's supposed to be fun and exciting. It's not very exciting, is it? Dang it! All right, so we'll just put him there. I was almost just thinking about doing this theater of the mind, but I don't know. Seemed like it might be a little hard, but. Alright, so that's his action. This other guy takes 3 points of damage. And he's already hurt from earlier, I guess. It's the same one. I don't know, what are they going to do if they're on the ground? How are they going to get back up? I guess they fall behind. Anyway, Castile, sorry.
Okay, so how does this work? So he's on the ground, so we're
going to
pass him?
You will, I guess, by the next round. I guess this is kind of taking place all simultaneously.
Okay.
All within the 6 seconds. So he won't be past him until next round, unless you want to try to do the move ahead bonus action. But...
Okay, and then, so can we still move? How does it work?
Yeah, I think so. I guess so, yeah, with the...
It's all weird. Or, like, the horse's static.
So that's what I'm thinking. The way they have it, it just says, in addition to standard actions, so I guess you could actually move, because I imagine you're moving at similar speeds, but...
Uh-huh.
I guess if you wanted to move just the movement rate of the horse, I would say that's fine. Nice. But I guess if you wanted to move ahead of everybody, you'd have to roll the animal handling check.
Yeah. So the horses are all wearing Barde.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
And got these dudes... And then what was it to try to jump on?
You can take an action, and it requires a successful DC 10 Dex acrobatics check.
Okay. Okay, I guess I'll just scoot up and try to hit the driver.
Okay.
Didn't roll my damage. Okay.
All right, so you hit this guy for 6. All right. Yeah, I guess that's really all I can do. Bonus actions are fall behind, move ahead. And the rest are all actions. So, I guess we'll go ahead and go to Crixus then.
Okay. So as we're riding along, could I maybe grab a branch of a tree and tear it off with the momentum of traveling at the speed? And
You're half orc, sure. Why not?
And
it's a real dead branch. And you're like, oh, that's a good, sure.
I was going to use it to try and jam in the wheel, but if it's a dead branch, it might just crumble.
Yeah, if it's a solid branch, there's no way you're gonna. I mean, it'll knock you off the horse. Yeah.
Okay.
But I'll give you a dead one. I mean, that's fine. If you want to be heroic and stuff.
Okay, I'll take a dead one, and this is a bit cruel and probably doesn't really fit the character, but I'm gonna try and stab or jab the horse in the eye with the.
Yeah. All right.
And they might be protected though, I guess, if they've got their armors.
No, I mean, you think that's bad. Wait till my turn.
I can only imagine.
Yeah.
Would that count as a crit obstacle, or is that an attack, or how are we gonna work?
Yeah, if you're gonna try to poke him in the eye, yeah, that's an attack. If attacking with what, the branch?
Yeah.
All right. It'd probably be like an improvised weapon, so you wouldn't get your proficiency bonus. Unless, I guess, if you were going to use it like a staff, I guess you can.
Yeah, I'll use it like, yeah. Use it like a
staff. All right, fine.
I think
this
could work. Oh, no,
that's
nothing.
Yeah, just be d20 plus your strength bonus plus your proficiency bonus. And I may be being more lenient on that rule, but all right. What is the horse's? You jab it in the eye, and it's like. So yeah, it's kind of going awkwardly.
That's me done. I don't have anything else to do.
Crixus, as you get close to this thing, or actually Castillo might be able to hear it too, but you hear what sounds like banging on the side of these wagons, and just like, help us, help us, please.
It's more sentient weapons.
I like it.
Singing swords.
Optimistic.
So this thing, I don't even think, well, all right, yeah, see what Ban does, and then the horse is almost gonna go out of control. Unless the red plume can get it under control on his round. So if he fails, then something bad's gonna happen, and the horse is gonna trip over.
Okay. Is hauling ass an action?
Move ahead. You can use a bonus action to try to get to haul ass in front of everybody.
I wanna get up to where this dude is. Like right in through here if I could.
Yeah, you can. You just gotta drag a circle. Yeah, highlight. But to do that, you have to roll a animal handling check.
I don't have it. Is that just the normal wisdom check
then? Yeah, wisdom. DC 10 wisdom. If you're proficient with land vehicles, you can add that, your proficiency to it.
No, I've got pilot airship for some reason.
Airship? Really? Yeah,
that,
nah.
Add awesome, that to the to-do list. Nah.
We got to get one. Yeah.
You manage not to to get the horse to get the speed, so you actually wind up...
Where am I?
You fall back a little bit.
Whoa!
Yeah. Echo says, failure results in the mount, or the horses leading... All right. Failure results in the mount, winding themselves, causing them to fall behind instead, so...
Boy, I made a mistake naming this horse Lightning.
That's funny. Yeah, you can still take an action, though, if you... Well, if you got anything ranged.
Well, I was going to cast Shield of Faith on myself.
Okay.
That's a concentrate, though, right?
Yeah. Well, just cast it now, and then next round we'll worry about that, so...
Okay.
So he's going to have to try to make an animal handling check to see, make sure this thing doesn't topple over. What is his check?
It's anticlimactic.
Alright, no bonus. Ho! Rolls a nat one. And so he gets a one for his animal handling check. He can't control the horse that Crixus poked in the eye, so it just goes out of control and then is like, and then kind of goes down and the whole thing just crashes. And so this one is down.
One down.
And these guys fall off. Oh, I can't make an X on it. Ah, dang it. There we go. And yeah, we'll just say these guys go flying and get kind of smushed. So we'll say these guys get knocked out because of that. And these guys
what
are
happens
like,
to the carriage? Does it tumble over or does it just stop?
It tumbles over, and you see it kind of break open, a part of it breaks open, and you see people's hands, like, out of it, help, help!
Well, they're not dead. Good job.
What are my options? Well, these guys are next, so... The plumes, they're driving, so he's going to have to keep driving. This guy is like, you fools. Where are his stats? Oh, crap. Yeah, we got to finish this in 10 minutes, this first one.
Keep poking the horses in the eyes.
Keep poking in the
eyes. So he... They're going, and he... Damn, forgot this dude is, like, right on him. Oh, that's cool. He is going to... Just try to, like, stab this guy with a dagger, try to get him off the thing. Shit, actually hits. And does wow, he actually, the guy had like hardly any hit points left, so this dude in robes gets a dagger and pokes the guy, and he falls off. And dies. Then he turns around. And I guess he can't do anything else. Actually, that's a... Yeah, I think that's a bonus. So he actually disappears. And he reappears. On this horse.
Not this again. I hate these guys.
Oops.
Under that horse.
And he just kind of gallops out a little bit. And that's him. This thing. Is going to see this little thing fly up and attack this thing. Yeesh. Does that hit? Nope, it doesn't hit. So, yeah. He's just flying around. And now it's Archon. And, oh, I think you're muted. Yeah.
Okay. How far can the horses move?
Let me see. The movement rate of riding horse. Speed is 60 feet. But you can, a bonus action, you can try to do an animal handling check to get ahead of everybody. To get like a boost of speed. But, yeah, as far as just regular movement, it's 60, so.
Okay, well. Because I really don't want that guy to get away, if I can help it. I'm going to try to edge some extra movement out of my horse. Nope.
Oh. And in doing so, you actually fall a bit behind.
Right. And unfortunately, I only could have gotten to, like, about there.
Alright.
Of course, I suppose I could have ridden up to there and then, like, you know, thrown one of my darts.
Or, produce flame or something. Alright, Lanso.
Alright, I only have to do the animal handling if I'm trying to get all the way to the front, is that correct?
Yep.
Okay, so I just want to move 60 and move right there. I am going to cast Flaming Sphere on this empty spot right there.
So all right.
That way, it is within 5 feet from the back two horses and the driver.
Catch the carriage on fire.
Yeah.
Drop right in between the horses.
Yeah, and all the prisoners.
It's not going to burn them up instantaneously.
No.
Start on fire or scorch it.
All right. And so, like, on his turn, he has to roll.
Well, I can ram it into one thing this turn, so let me...
Okay.
And so just for horse. Fun. Yeah, I should just do the horse.
The horse?
Right,
okay.
Whole thing right now.
Whoa.
That's not a very powerful one, but it might mess him up. So I'll cast it, like, right here, and then roll it down to boom, and just smack one of the horses so it's sitting right in the middle there.
So the sphere has gravity, right? It just, you put it there, and if you drop it off, it's gonna fall, right? Like
it rolls. It just kind of rolls. So I can roll it around and stuff like that, and I'm just gonna roll it to where it's on the right where they're supposed to be sitting. And anybody within 5 feet of it that ends their turn has to make a dex save.
Dex save on right away or on their turn?
Only on the person I run it into. But yeah, I don't want to roll. I don't want to take the chance of rolling it.
I'll just
leave it right there.
So one of the horses would have to.
Yeah, if you would deem that I was able to roll it into one.
That's
of
fine.
The
it fails the save. So it would be 5 fire.
So it's up to you what a horse would do when his ass is on fire.
He's not liking it. So he's gonna go out of control unless this dude can get up with him. What is that? That's the bandits. Okay. This guy's he's kind of clinging on. He's gonna. Oh shit! He's this is a bunch of fire and shit there. So.
It's up to you to determine if he's within 5 feet or over 5 feet from it, because I have it kind of on the center.
Right here. That's. I guess technically he's out of five. If it's right in the intersection.
Yeah.
That would be he would be out, but he was gonna try to climb up, but he was like, "Whoa!" So he's like, "Oh!" So he's just gonna hang on and try to hit him with a mace or whatever. So, all right, hits him, does 4 damage. All right, takes a little chunk out of him, but guy's still up. Other guy's dead. this is the guy that fell prone. Shit. So he actually would have fallen back. He'd be back here. My bad. So. It's not. Retroactive. Continuity.
So that'd be like, use my reaction to like.
But if he's
if you really wanted to, I guess you can try. Like, that'd be cool. Like, hey, sure, why not? If you want to use your bonus or your reaction, sure, why not? Do you like acrobatics check? Yeah, say
that
get
would be heroic.
10 or higher. Ah, oh, yay! That's pretty cool.
Get up here.
So. You like do like the old westerns. And you're like, oh, lean down, and like
grab
go.
The hand, leap them up. The
That's pretty awesome. All right, inspiration for that, man. That's pretty cool. So he is there. Oops, I put the horse. Okay, here we go. All right, I'm gonna mute him. No. who are?
He'll just annoy this guy and make it difficult for him to. He'll actually go up here and ignore, annoy this guy, making it difficult for him to do anything.
I thought you were gonna get some familiar on familiar action, but no, I know.
Yeah.
Like Pokemon.
Yeah. I choose you.
So this guy's gonna try to make a animal handling check. He has to roll a saving throw, right? For your atmosphere deck save.
That's at the
end. Oh, at the end? Well, he fails, so we'll see if he can. Dang! Rolling low tonight on my end. He does not, so he takes the damage from the sphere and
then the other horse, too.
Yep.
That's the big thing. He's trying to stop it.
Let's see. Draft horse. Wow. 7. So the horse fails. So, yeah, the front one is totally just smashed. It is down for the count. And with that, the second one basically rams into the other one, and they're all wrecked and down. So
get those people out of those carriages.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. The you hear screams from the front. It's on fire! Help us!
Always whining.
Just a second, ingrates.
Rescue me! Put me up! Put the fire out of me! Jeez!
Yeah, one thing after another.
Always, I know. It's so hot! Oh, my hair's gone!
You see this guy on the robes? He's basically he books it and he escapes. Yeah.
Oh, we can't take an attempt to chase him.
We're out of time. I mean,
all right. Yeah. All
right. And these guys are going. If you want to try to get pop shots on these, you can. Just whoever wants to attack is in range can attack. But they're trying to. Oh no, they were unconscious. Yeah. My bad.
Yeah,
they're unconscious. These guys might have some hit points, so if you want to take a pop shot off him, you can. This thing disappears. When you got up close to it, Lance, it looked like it was definitely a weird kind of familiar, like some kind of maybe even like a
demonic.
Yeah. Demonic familiar. So yeah, you got people yelling for help. What do you do?
Start busting them out of there if anybody's hurt.
Start busting them out for help.
Crack it open.
All right, you bust them out.
We did most of the work. They can finish up the rest.
Wow. That's a true half work for you.
I've got some healing I can offer if anybody's really beat up.
Are they all demi-humans in there?
Yeah. You find... Yeah, a bunch of people... This is such a hard mod to follow. Cargo revealed. Okay. All right. Well, cool. Since you stopped it early, you get bonus XP. Oh, and you get more XP because Crix has heard them crying. That's cool. Yeah. I guess because you got close enough, you can hear them. Caravan is caught. Regardless, she's bringing an point in the way. Destroy a sergeant runner's structure. Okay, well, we skipped that part. So. Where are the people?
They're all mangled up and burned corpses.
They're all dead.
No.
What the hell? It doesn't have it in here? Come on. Come on, guys. Hang on. It's got to be in here. Come on.
I think Archon and myself should get some experience for our strategic fallback maneuver in order to control the path behind us and keep the rest of the party safe.
Picking up all the stragglers, that's right.
Yeah, making sure we didn't get flanked by any reinforcements.
Exactly. Exactly. Prove me wrong. All
right. There we go. Microscope. Yeah, basically you find a total of 8 rather shaken captives. Yeah, among them is only one human. The others are a mix of elves, halfling dwarves, and half-elves.
Oh, we did all this for 8. They sure made a lot of noise for just 8 people.
Are they like farmers from the communities around here? Or?
Yeah.
I just want a human. Got to talk to the human person. Mm-hmm. What'd he do to piss them off?
Kind of pointy ears.
Ben, you said you got one of the sergeant's. You picked up the sergeant's longsword, right?
Yeah.
I
have a thing for longswords. The paladin thing.
You notice, then you're checking it out for a second. You notice that there looks like there's a concealed compartment in the hilt of it.
What?
Yeah.
Crazy.
And it looks like there's some kind of document in there.
I hope it's in common. Is it like instructions or?
It's in common, but it's it looks like some kind of document, some kind of contract, almost an agreement between what looks like him and a pair of Durgar slavers.
Oh, is it those two jerks that we fought in that basement? Remember those guys?
No, you killed them.
Yeah, but I'm just saying. Is it
Yeah, the same type. Yeah.
So these guys are being picked up with the slave trade.
Yeah, they're not going to deal with non-humans except to sell other non-humans to those non-humans.
So yeah, eventually the bandits on foot catch up, and they're like, "Oh my goodness!" And then you see the dwarf guy come out. He's like, "Ugh, you see what I'm telling you? You don't know what these guys are going to be up to." And he's,
"Oh, we know what they're up to. I'll show them the document."
Ugh. He's like, "Document? What did you find?"
They're enslaving you people and selling you to the enemy.
I don't think we need to sell.
Why?
What to who?
Yeah,
To the Underdark, to the minions of the Underdark.
The Underdark. Oh.
Do they say where they were delivering these people to?
Underdark.
A specific spot, though, because I don't think these red plumes are going to take the caravan into the Underdark.
Yeah, no, they're going to meet him in a cave somewhere or something.
Ben, you might know. There's really only one location that you think it could be. And it is, you know, that a little bit ahead there is it's a roadside shrine, and it has to do with it was actually a point in it's actually, I guess, I think the main statue there is a statue to Tempest, which I believe is the god of war.
Yeah.
Sounds like my kind of guy.
He is.
And it was dedicated, or basically about the Battle of Falling Wasps and the heroic efforts of the Red Plumes defending against the Zint. Ground troops and sky mages.
Yeah.
So you have a feeling that they're probably going to meet up with them there. If you wanted to confront them, you could go there. But it's up to you, considering it's past 11. And if you want to try to do the other adventure, we have to really start it now. If you just want to do this adventure now, we can, you can try to see if you can confront them. But,
well, so, Jason, did you get my message that I sent?
Oh. Okay. You do not see anybody with that description.
Okay. Can I question the human that's here? Why he's a prisoner?
You just please say, I don't know. I guess they didn't like what I said. I defended my fellow.
He's an elf lover. He's a 30 elf lover.
Hey. I guess that could just be simple as that, because I didn't see myself doing anything wrong. I don't know. I don't. These guys are crazy, man. These guys are crazy.
Ah, you like the elven ladies.
Well,
don't worry, man. I do too.
I will tell my party that I'm, because they're probably wanting to not pursue. I will tell them that, hey, there's a particular half elf that I'm trying to find, that I think was kidnapped. You know, I was hoping he'd be in this caravan though, but there's a chance he might be at that other location then.
Well, I have an idea about that other location. If we can recover one of these carts, we can make ourselves look like red plumes and take a cart, and the demi humans can ride in the back. Like, I think. It's just like you and Crixus.
I don't think they'd be too keen on getting back in another cart and heading to where they were being taken.
No, I'm talking about Crixus and Lance, not the people that were enslaved.
Yeah. They can ride back. No, I like it. Yeah, yeah, if we can salvage at least one of these to use parts or something like
that. You would think,
and then we can roll up on them.
What was it? Maybe the front one, definitely not. Was it the middle one? There was one of them that didn't really seem like it took as much. Probably the middle one.
Yeah. The middle one,
But I think the second one was probably more from smush the horses, because there's really four horses, and so yeah, the middle one probably. You might have to use your own horses, but yeah, I could say it's doable.
How far do we think the place was away?
Because I thought we were doing these adventures to get XP for Antoine and Max. If we continue with this adventure, are we going to have enough XP?
That's well, the thing about these is there's a minimum XP. Like, when we were in the Underdark, there was no minimum, so I had to give you just whatever you accumulated. But these, I can give you a minimum of 450. So I have to give you at least the minimum if it doesn't add up. But you can get a maximum of 600. It just depends. If you want to try to get more XP, you can try to.
Castile, how much did you need?
900.
Oh, and I say we got to do the more important thing then.
As Phil, for people with special assignments, if they don't complete their assignment, I'll just say they don't get the extra renown point. So there's that. That's but okay. So yeah, I.
Just out of curiosity, though, was he there?
Yeah, I need 950.
The person you're looking for, he's not in the caravans. Is that?
Oh, no, I was thinking he's at that next spot. But we're gonna skip. I think we're gonna skip it anyways, then, to save time, so we can do the other mini one to get these guys where they need to be.
Okay.
That makes sense.
Okay.
I don't see a lot of benefit for the faction stuff anyways. Maybe much later when you're like level 15 or something crazy like that. But
well, I know, yeah, and I think the main thing, if you have Rage of Demons background, I think two of those will help either get rid of the madness or prevent madness. I think it's Emerald Enclave and Harper's, though.
Yeah, I think the Order of the Gauntlet has the one that you can spend.
Okay. Yeah, I wasn't Sure, there could have been more, yeah. So I'm going to write down Durgar escapes. All right, so I'll just get on to the next one then. You free the guys and...
Bada bing, bada boom.
Bada bing, bada boom.
Well, I'll give that document I have to Lance if he wants to pursue it further and later on down the line looking for that dude.
Oh, that's just a good idea.
Just in character.
Come by their place. We'll see if they're there, maybe. Who knows? Mm-hmm.